Reproduction. Reproduction is the formation of similar young organisms by the grown up organism. Here you can see an amoeba. Here a grown up amoeba is giving rise to daughter amoeba. This is called reproduction. Reproduction is meant for perpetuation of the species. Perpetuation means continuation of a species, continuity. So this reproduction is chiefly responsible for the formation of populations. Without reproduction, there is no any formation of population. Populations are due to this reproduction only. Reproduction, similar kind of organisms are regenerated. This reproduction is of different kinds. So here you can see the classification of reproduction in animals. It is a different in plants. Here this is of two important kinds. First one, you know, that is asexual reproduction. Asexual reproduction means no formation of gametes. The second one you can see here as a sexual reproduction. The sexual reproduction, the most common type of reproduction among animals. So first one, this asexual reproduction we are studying here in this video. This is of different kinds. So the first kind is a called a fission. Fission means simply splitting or a cell division. Cell division is fission. Second one is called very easier one, that is called budding. So these buds we can see in a different kinds of organisms. So in the case of fungus, yeast also shows budding. So here animals are also showing budding, you will see in this video later. So next one is a fragmentation is there, and then a regeneration of the last parts of the body. So here first one is a fission. This fission is of two kinds, that is, one is a binary fission. If one cell is divided into two cells, we call it binary fission. If the cell divides into a number of daughter cells, then we call it as a multiple fission. Multiple means many. So first one is a binary fission. This is again of two kind, that is longitudinal binary fission. That means if an organism, if a cell divides longitudinal plane, we call longitudinal. Another is transverse. If it is divided transversely, we call it as a transverse binary fission, longitudinal binary fission. The example here is euglena. For a transverse binary fission, the example is a paramecium. So next one is a multiple fission. For multiple fission, we can take a plasmodium, malarial parasite, as an example. For budding, the best example we can see here among animals, that is a hydra. Whereas in the case of fragmentation, regeneration, we have see different kinds of animals, like lizards, hydra is there, planaria are there. So in the same way, earthworms, lizards, salamanders. So like that, we can see different kinds of animals with respect to regeneration. Different kinds of animals, but most of them are invertebrates. Some invertebrates like lizards are also showing the process of regeneration. Whereas these examples you write down in your notes. So whereas sexual reproduction is a common among almost all animals. So asexual reproduction occurs within the without the fusion of gametes. Here in this case, no gamete formation. Gamete means sexual cells which are produced in the gonads. This process is not there, not at all. Here you can see a very big egg at the center that is surrounded by a number of sperms. So likewise, no fertilization, no formation of gametes, no fusion of gametes occurs. So here, whereas in the case of asexual reproduction results in the formation of identical offspring called clones. You can see here one sponge is there. A number of bits of that organism. You can see here a hydra. From one parent hydra, a number of daughter hydra are being produced. So all are identical in a size, shape, in a genetical constitution, and also in their functionality, their performance. So likewise, a number of hydra are being produced. So this is the most important advantage of asexual reproduction. Clones are produced. They are similar in their shape and size, but sexual reproduction has many advantages. Asexual reproduction takes place only through mitosis. Here no case of no meiosis occurs. So meiosis is sexual kind of cell division. So you can see here one cell is being divided into two daughter cells. So this process is called mitosis. Mitosis is very, very important with respect to asexual reproduction. So very, very important aspect with respect to asexual reproduction is totipotency. Totipotency is a cell's ability to differentiate into other cell types. So this is a basic principle involved in a tissue culture also. Tissue culture and asexual reproduction, this totipotency, one cell differentiates into different kinds of cells. So this property is used in the propagation of plants, different kinds of plants through asexual vegetative reproduction, and also a number of lower animals. See, you can see here one cell is differentiated into different kinds of cells. The different colors indicate different kinds of cells. So in this case, you can see this green, blue, light blue, this kind of yellow colors, all these things, they are nothing but different kinds of cells. So this property is very, very useful in the case of asexual reproduction and vegetative reproduction. In binary fission, the mature individual divides into two equal sized daughter individuals. So bi means two, binary means two individuals will be formed binary. Likewise, you can see here one cell divided into two. Binary fission takes place in any plane in amoeba. Amoeba, so it is irregular in shape. You can see in the picture, irregular. So in any plane, you can see amoeba gif image you can see here. Amoeba, you see, irregular in shape, so there is no any definite shape for amoeba. It can split into different planes. You can see these diagonal planes, so these red arrows indicate. So this one results in amoebulae. The daughter amoebae are also called as amoebulae. You can see here two daughter amoeba. Next one you can see so longitudinal binary fission takes place in euglena and verticella. So here you can see euglena has a flagellated protozoan is called euglena. Euglena can be split into longitudinal plane. You can see the arrow mark, longitudinal arrow mark. So that's why we call it as a longitudinal binary fission. It is resulting in the formation of two daughter euglena, similar to that kind of the mother. Here again you see one mother verticella cell. So this verticella we can call as a bell animalcule. Also it is a bell in a shaped. So here also you can see the arrow mark. This arrow mark is a very vertical and longitudinal. That's why we can call it as a longitudinal binary fission. It is resulting in a two verticella cells. So like O is a one verticella cell and the second verticella cell. So this is a longitudinal binary fission. Next we can see transverse binary fission. Transverse means horizontal. Transverse binary fission takes place in paramecium. You know paramecium, a very famous protozoan. The nickname of the paramecium is a slipper animalcule. It is a divided transversely, horizontally, unlike that of euglena. In euglena verticella, longitudinal division we have seen. Here in this case we can see horizontal division or transverse division. We call it as a transverse binary fission. Two paramecium cells are being formed. So next one is you can see in paramecium, micronucleus divides by mitosis and macronucleus divides by mitosis. As we have already know, paramecium consists of two kinds of nuclei. A bigger one is macro, smaller one is a micronucleus. Micronucleus, that green arrow mark indicates division of micronucleus, whereas the red arrow mark indicates the division of the macronucleus. Micronucleus divides by a process called mitosis, whereas the macronucleus divides by a process called mitosis. Next one you can see oblique binary fission takes place in dinoflagellate. Dinoflagellates are also animals, unicellular animals. They form a primary zooplankton in seas and oceans. So here you can see neither vertical nor horizontal, here oblique diagonal division. You can see this kind of binary fission is called oblique binary fission. It is resulted into the formation of two dinoflagellate cells. Next one is a multiple fission takes place in amoeba, plasmodium and monocystis. Plasmodium and monocystis are the protozoan parasites. They are living inside the human body, whereas in the case amoeba, you can see one amoeba is getting number of amoebulae. So this is a multiple fission in a amoeba. You can see the multiple fission in plasmodium, a malarial parasite also. So number of sporozoites are being formed due to multiple fission. So next one is in fission, karyokinesis, that is nuclear division, is followed by cytokinesis, that is a cytoplasmic division. Two important processes here. You can see cytokinesis, where cytoplasm is dividing the cell into two daughter cells. So here before that, karyokinesis takes place. Here nucleus is divided into two smaller nuclei. This is first. Second one is cytokinesis. A cell with a very thick wall to tide over unfavorable conditions, it is called a cyst or a spore, especially amoeba. You can see that yellow colored pot is an amoeba cell. So just a schematic diagram, you consider it as amoeba cell, around which a blue colored very thick pot, that is called a cell wall, or the outermost layer of the cell wall, that is called a cyst. So cell inside, over that very thick cyst is formed to tide over unfavorable conditions. Next important kind of asexual reproduction is budding. In budding, a small bulb-like projection coming out from the cell, that is called a bud. Example, hydra, flatworms, jellyfish, sea anemones, and corals. So you can see budding in the case of hydra in this diagram. So first one is a hydra, mother hydra is there. So you can see how the bird a projection grows slowly, and that is developing tentacles also. So finally that these three things, these are development of bird. You can see here this one is a detachment of a bird into an independent daughter hydra. This is called budding. So in the same way, in the case of sponges, internal buds are called gemmules, example sponges. So this is a different kind of buds, internal buds. So in this diagram you can see one sponge. So inside the sponge, so this is sponge, so this total organism is a sponge. Inside this organism you can find a development of spherical shaped buds. These are called gemmules. They are developing one after the other. So this way sponges reproduce asexually by developing buds or gemmules. inside there a spongocele. Spongocele is the cavity, you can see inside the cavity over the wall of the sponge, gemmules are being developed. It is very, very easy. This is not at all difficult thing. You can see here gemmules. You can see one simple kind of asexual reproduction is called fragmentation. Fragmentation is splitting of a organism into bits called fragments. Example, sponges, you can see corals, you can see flatworms, annelids, some annelids, worms, and sea stars. So fragmentation, this is a kind of a regeneration. You can see a flatworm is being split into three equal bits or unequal bits also. Each bit will further develop into an independent organism. So this kind of process is called fragmentation. Fragment means one bit, you can see here. So this is a flatworm. Flatworm belongs to Planaria. This one is that green arrow indicates a flatworm. So this next one, these three ones, we call them as a fragment. These three ones we call them as a fragments. So remaining, you can see there three organisms, three flatworms, daughter flatworms. Will be developing three fragments. Okay, so next one is a independent life of fragments. Fragments will develop. So next, regeneration is the process of renewal, restoration and growth of organisms from a loss. When any organism loses any part of its body, any bit of the body, that will be regenerated. We also show regeneration in the case of healing of wounds, but our body won't be developed regenerated as it in the case of a lower organism. Hydra planarian platforms, earthworms, you can see newts, starfish, and lizards. In this case, you can find a regeneration. Here you can see a starfish, it has lost its one arm. That how that arm is developing, you can see the process. Thus it is a cycle, very well healthy and complete. A starfish loses its one arm. See, next the arm is developing slowly. So this kind of regeneration is helpful in a renovation or a renewal or a regeneration of the organisms. So loss of an arm and regenerated with arm. You can see here, you can see lizards, how they are losing. So here caudata, that is urodils, tailed amphibians, the salamanders and newts, how they are regenerating, you can see here. The biological process that involves limb regeneration is called autotomy. This is a very famous In the case of lizards, this only one schematic diagram you can see how the tail regenerated. So here you can see autotomy. During autotomy, the animal detaches a limb or tail to avoid capture by a predator. If any enemy comes, so that will loses its tail. So in the case of earthworm segments 6x7 to 23rd segment regeneration is very well. So if earthworm by accident loses its segments, so it also can regenerate like this from 6th to 23rd segments. Okay, after this you please write down the notes and you don't waste time, and you review the old videos also, and you attempt the response sheet and submit now itself. Okay, thank you.